I shall not mourn till war is done. I shall not weep while blood still runs.
The spirit mouths the words to a mourning song. If you listen carefully, you can hear her whisper.
I shall not mourn till war is done. I shall not weep while blood still runs. I'll hold my tears when weeping comes. And I'll avenge my darling one.
She turns back to her fallen self once more, her eyes glistening.
Hidden bridge. Clever. Very clever.
Do you have it? Do you have the book I seek? Found the little corpse-related book I seek yet? Have a look. Mind you don't tear any pages now. You know what I'm looking for.
There's a boat at the dock. Perhaps it may take us to the island.
Shall I take you to the island? I shall. I shall. Step this way. All aboard. A trifling amount, I'm sure you'll agree. Payable in advance, of course. Payment in advance. Wouldn't want all aboard. The bell is ringing. Step careful as you disembark. Wouldn't want you to get hurt as you die upon the dock. In the interest of efficiency and to ensure my quick return to the mainland, please empty your pockets in advance. Thank you. Please, come again. I didn't lie. I just asked you to trust me. The mistake is yours. I could have spent a little less time circling around in the mist, but I like to offer value for money.
lies ahead looks even less welcoming.
She screams. And screams. And screams and never stops to screams. The roots quake and my bones quiver and still the screaming. The tree's the girl and the girl's the tree. And she screams and screams.
Quite the crowd.
You don't need me to tell you that.
You! The advocate has been waiting.
I'm in deep.
The knight leans in, a strange look of panic in his eyes that doesn't quite match his powerful voice.
Thanks.
Go! We have wasted enough time here, and he is not a patient creature.
Skipping stones.
Dark words should not sully those honey lips. All will be well.
He has faith in them, darling. That is all we need.
Greetings and salutations. Have no fear, we mean you no harm.
The being sniffs the air in your direction and licks his lips. He moves a couple of paces towards you, his eyes hungry and entranced. He abruptly slaps himself in the face and halts his advance.
My manners. Master would not be pleased. He awaits you west of here. He will not harm you. Others may. A servant. A loyal servant.
He wrings his hands as he answers you, wrings them bloody.
Loyal and hungry. Go now. Save your questions from Master. Spare me your presence.
He doesn't respond at first. Instead, he stares, consuming you with his eyes. He bites his frayed lower lip, drawing blood.
Master is Master. He wants you to go to him, west of here.
He barely seems to notice your repeated question at first. His eyes are dark pools in which your reflection is drowning.
You are so delicious. Please, go west. My master awaits.
Dark words should not sound.
Ah, there you are, and with just the little demonic host I've been looking for. You don't mind if I have a word with Maslosa, do you? I was just curious about the progress of your little hunt.
I met your old buddy Jahan, if that's what you mean.
I don't have buddies. I have associates. So, did he help you with the, matter at hand?
He's putting me through my paces. I have a few more hoops to jump through before he'll help me.
Nothing in life is free, I suppose. Make sure you do jump them, Losa. You won't be sorry.
The lizard's eyes are dark as polished coal, void of all light. A faint frost seems to cover the cracked and broken scales around his mouth.
You have a reputation for both malfeasance and chaos. Imagine my surprise when it took you so long to find your way here. I see the miasma surrounding our islet certainly did not hinder you. Well, here you stand, in the flesh, so to speak. And a finer collection of corpusculae I never have seen. I trust you are not opposed to a mutually beneficial accord between civil and gentle persons. Ah, a curious mind. A most glorious creation. I am here at the behest of my master to offer you a simple exchange. An offer of aid for the promise of aid. The epitome of civil reciprocity. You and he possess a common foe. The power behind the Voidwoken has made our lives hell, so to speak. Since the Divine Order unleashed death fog against the Black Ring and those darling woodland creatures. And as the gods have shirked their duty, perhaps we could come to a mutually beneficial arrangement pertaining to both of our objectives. Indeed, I can offer you the source channel that you seek forthwith, as a gesture of good faith. My, what a firm response. Hasty and moronic, but firm. Very well. I suspect I shall still be here when you change your mind. And you will change your mind, Godwoken.
Did you hear what he said? The death fog ushered in the rise of the Voidwoken, and whatever gruesome power controls them. Every day we learn more about the ills of the death fog that the Divine Order detonated. The Order I served. And now we learn it also birthed something awful. Something that plagues every corner of the world.
Ifan's eyes blaze with rage, and his fists are clenched so tightly the knuckles are white. As he howls his anger free, you hear the echoing howl of his trusty soul. Together they roar in tandem, grief, loss, and rage. When Ifan is howled hoarse, you feel his anger slink away like a whipped cur. Yet his soul wolf remains.
Let's go. Redemption's not won by sitting still.